Hey guys, what's up? Well, Halloween's coming up, so check out the new model I just designed. This is the jack-o'-lantern flicker, and this is how it flies. Whoa, wanna learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for these jack-o'-lanterns, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of kami. You could use a sheet of printer paper cut square, but then you're not going to have the facial features, unless you color one side of the sheet of printer paper so that you have one side colored and one side white. Let's begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now rotate and fold in half in this direction. And now rotate again so that the four corners, 1, 2, 3, 4, are down. And let's take two of them, 1, 2, and bring them up about this much. Now this distance right here is how far the eye is going to be from the edge. So if you want the eye closer, you'll fold it further up. I think that this is about good, like that. And try to keep it centered. Now we're going to fold these two flaps up. We're trying to divide the diagonal of this square into thirds. So fold it up and just try to make it so that this distance is equal to this distance. So fold it about like this. And don't fold it too firmly because you want
to be able to adjust it if you need to.
So now bring these two flaps down, and you might just need to fiddle with the folds a little bit. I'm going to bring this a little bit down, and like that. I think I got thirds. And if you did it right, you'll see that this edge hits at this intersection. Okay, now bring one flap up. And now we're going to try to divide the diagonal of this square into thirds. So fold this up, and this length should be equal to this length. And fold it down like that. Okay, and now fold this corner up so that it hits this line. Just imagine that this line continues and fold the corner up to that line. And now let's fold these two flaps down
so that the fold touches
this edge. Like that. And fold one flap up. And now fold it down so that the fold aligns with this edge. So the two folds touch like that. And now we're going to try to divide this flap into thirds. So fold it up about like this and fold it down. And that doesn't need to be perfect, but just do your best, like that. And those are the teeth of the scary monster. I mean, the jack-o'-lantern. Okay, and now try to match this flap with this flap. So fold it up about like this. We want this edge and this edge to match. We want this edge and this edge to match. So it's about like that. And now fold this flap into thirds. So fold it down about like that. And fold it up. And that doesn't need to be perfect. Okay. So here we have the basic face. The scary face. And if you want to make it happy, then you just hide it like that. You might want to bring this flap down a little bit to make it look happier. Like that. You can adjust those pleats however you want. Okay, so there is the happy jack-o'-lantern, and it goes wah, like that. And if you want triangular eyes, what you can do is just take this flap and fold this triangle behind, like that. And now fold this flap behind, right on this crease. So fold it like that and let this point flip up like that. And we still want the nose in front. So this is what it looks like, and from the side in there, you see, it's like that. Okay. So here we have the triangular eye, triangular nose, jack-o'-lantern, and might as well just hide that for now, because I think it's gonna fly better if there's just one flap here. Okay, let's fold this flap behind. We're just rounding the jack-o'-lantern to taste. So yeah, I'd say about like that is good. And try to match it on the other side. This is to taste. And crease those well. And if you want, you can fold this flap behind. I think it's good to fold it behind because this right here is a raw edge, and that'll maybe not make the model fly as well as a folded edge. So yeah, fold that behind like that. From this side, that's what it looks like. And let's do the same thing on this side. So we're just folding the flap behind so that the fold touches this point. And lastly, let's make the stem of the pumpkin. So fold it down, and this is also to taste. If you want a taller jack-o'-lantern, you'll fold it up like this. Shorter, you'll fold it like that. And turn over and fold this up to taste. You might want to estimate thirds since we've been doing that so much in this model. Okay, and crease it and turn over. And here we have the completed smiling jack-o'-lantern. And just make all of the folds really sharp. If you want, you can use the edge of a table and just kind of slide it on the edge of the table like this, and that'll get these folds nice and sharp. And it'll also make it round a little bit, which will look maybe a little bit nicer. Give it a hint of 3D. And also, if you round it enough, then you might be able to get it to stand. Or not. There, I guess I should go down so it's like that. Okay, let's try to fly this thing.
Alright, so to fly this thing, it's basically like an ordinary flicker. You just want to hold it face up and try to hit this edge with your index finger. Here goes. That was pretty good. Now to make it fly a little bit better, what you can do is take these two side flaps and just fold them inside. So it's like that, and same on this side. Just tuck the flap inside, like that. And also go around the perimeter and make the folds extra, extra, extra sharp. And you can also try to curve the top. That way the flaps won't stick out, because when they stick out, that's when it really doesn't fly very well. So you curve it like that. And I think that the curvature also helps it give some lift. So here goes. And also when you flick it, try to make your hand go forward. Make sure it doesn't go down like that, because otherwise it's not gonna fly. All right, here goes. Blah. Another thing you can do is tuck the nose in, because that is a troublesome flap. so you'll end up with a noseless jack-o'-lantern just for the flight. Here goes. Oh yeah, that was sweet. Here goes again. Yeah! All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed folding that. I hope you guys have a happy Halloween and enjoy flying your new jack-o'-lantern flicker. And I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye. And this is how it flies. And this is how it flies. And this is how it flies.